What's up, y'all? This is Hussein Nasser from iGeometry, and let us continue with our beautiful calculator here. All right, what we're building today? What did we do last time? We did most of these buttons. Now we can write in full equation, right? We can do coolish stuff. We can clear. We can do a division, but we can do, we can even do decimal. Ooh, zeros. All right, so we can do all that stuff. What are we missing? We're missing the evaluation. It's really, really simple to evaluate that puppy. So let's go ahead and open our calculator. That is our calculator right there, guys. All right. Look at all that. Look at all this code, guys. Ooh. All right. What are we going to do now? So we want, when we click on that evaluation or equal button, right? We want to evaluate whatever expression is there on the result. Is that what it's called? It's called result. Okay. The good thing is that we already fetched that. We fetched the result object. So we have that object. Okay. So what we're going to do here is actually it's try to evaluate that. Let's just do that for a second here. We have a lot of code here. See, that's the last code. We introduced another type of function last time, trying to be fancy. That's called the arrow functions, where we actually reset. We click, like, if someone click clear, we reset all the values or the zeros on that. So we're gonna do something similar actually today here. As do we have a button in the equal? Did we give it a name? Did we give it a name, sir? Let me hide myself here so you can actually see the code. All right, what did we call that again? We called it equal. And guess what? We actually did not pull that icon. So let's just go ahead and equal document dot get element by ID. And it's called equal. So let's just call it that. Very simple, very basic. All right, so now, if someone clicks on equal, we want to do something fancy here. What are we gonna do, man? So let's just use arrow functions again. I'm really I like those. Just one line that does everything. And by the way, in JavaScript you can just, by the way, break things into multiple lines. It doesn't have to be like it's one single line, right? Okay. What do we want to do here? It's really simple. So the good thing is I already have that object, the result, right? And what I want to do is actually evaluate that result. So literally say result dot text content is equal to result dot, all right, bye, dot text content, but we'll introduce a new function called eval, which is literally a built-in function. Evaluate the supplied string as a JavaScript code. Can you imagine how cool this is, right? So you give it a string, and what it does is actually evaluate that string as if it was a code. Basically, like 1 plus 1 minus 3, and then it will actually evaluate that and then compute the result. What are we going to do after the computing the result of that highlighted portion is put that value in this. And you can just ignore the E. I just added that so we avoid the parentheses. I'm back. All right. How about that? Let's just save and try that. I think you can do that too. Yeah, you can do anything you want. Whatever is more readable for you guys, just feel free and do it. Just, you can write the code like that. You can write in one line. You can write, break it in multiple lines. It's all good. So let's do 9 plus 9. And they say eval. Ooh, that's a revelation right there, guys. Oh, man. 6 plus 3. 9. Is it 9? Yes. Okay, 9 times 99 times 9. Yeah, why not? Sweet. Sweet. 3 plus 3 plus 1. 7. Holy mama. Look at that. Plus. Uh-oh. That's wrong. Uh-oh. So, if you did something wrong and if you equal, it's actually, it will try to evaluate it. Sometimes it will fail. Like in this case, it will just do nothing. And we'll handle that in other cases. But like if you get 6 plus minus 6, what does that mean? It's actually 0. 6 plus minus 6. Think as if there are parentheses on this, right? So we'll do the parentheses in the next episode, I think. And I'm going to make this much, much clearer. All right, so let's just do more cool stuff. 9 over 3. So as you start doing multiple things, it will not become as clear as, you know, the result of, there's always like in multiplication and division and math, you know, there's always a function that is preferred over the other, like certain operators are preferred, like a multiplication is preferred over the operands, such as the addition and the sub, right? So, yeah, look at that, 9 minus 6 plus, I'm having so much fun. Can we do some more? Can we do a decimal? 3.3 plus 3.3. Uh-oh, it does not like that. We'll need to find out why it didn't fail. So 6 plus 1.1. Huh, it actually worked, okay. So we need to fix that extra zero, which is useless, all right? So we'll fix that. And maybe in the next episode, right? So, yeah. So, I think like 18 plus 3.1, it's 21.1. So, 3.3 plus 3.3, it did not like that one. And I think that's because of the extra zero that we're gonna fix as well. So, yeah. Let's just take it light today, guys, and stick with that as a result. So we have, I think we have a functioning calculator. Obviously, there are a lot of things like division by zero, you know, infinity, right? Well, there's a debate whether it's infinity or not. But yeah. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed this episode. I'm going to see you in the next one. Stay tuned. Bye-bye. Hey, guys. So some of you suggested that I end each of these episodes with a quiz or kind of a question so you guys can take the time and try exercise it for yourself. And it'll be, I think it's a great idea. So I'll start to do that starting this episode. So sorry I didn't catch that suggestion later, but yeah, so try this, guys, okay? So try solving this problem with the tools that we learned so far, right? You can search the net for other tools, but just in general, this is the problem that we have. If I click on, start over, if I click on any digit, I'm starting to add. You will notice that the zero is getting appended to, right? So regardless, whatever we add, we always add the zero. So the zero sometimes makes sense to add, sometimes it doesn't, right? So like if it's an operator, like plus, yeah, it's okay, right? Zero plus six. But it doesn't make sense to add 09 or 08, or right? So this is the fix. If I clicked on a digit, do not append, right? If the current, if I click on a digit, do not append that zero. Try to not append that zero. If I click on anything else, it will be okay, right? So 0, 1, 2, 3 through 9, just replace the zero with the number instead, right? So it's just, it will be something like that. Like that. So if it's 0, click 8. But if it's 0 and a plus, it actually takes the plus into consideration, right? Dot works too, right? You can append it. So work on that, guys. And I'm going to see you in the next episode. And we're going to fix that problem in the next episode. Stay tuned.